Where do you think this image was taken? Looks like another image taken from a rover actively exploring the surface of Mars, right? Well, if we zoom out, we can see that this is not Mars. Instead, these images were taken on Earth's largest uninhabited island, which due to its absurdly cold climate and visible appearance is often compared with the surface of Mars. What I am referring to is Devon Island, a remote landmass which spans an area of 55,247 square kilometers or 21,331 square miles. In other words, this completely uninhabited landmass is about the same size as the U.S. state of West Virginia or the nation of Croatia. And with images like this, and this, it is not a surprise that NASA uses this distinct location as a Mars analog to test and train NASA astronauts in hopes of eventually sending humans to Mars. But just how similar is this remote fascinating location to an assumed landing on the Martian equator? Here is a quick rundown. Aspects such as yearly high temperatures and the presence of an impact crater Devon Island has in common with Mars, while aspects such as yearly precipitation and presence of fossils are not exactly as close. Mars, of course, also has no yet confirmed life forms on its surface, and yet Devon Island is host to occasional animals such as polar bears and muskox. So, where is Devon Island? How did it become such a large uninhabited island? Where is its large impact crater, and what secrets does this remote location hold? Today's video will answer all of these questions. Devon Island can be found in the frigid Canadian Arctic above the Arctic Circle, 3,500 kilometers or 2,175 miles north of the city of Toronto. Devon Island was most recently inhabited by humans between 1924 and 1951 at a spot called Dundas Harbor, but the extremely cold climate, lack of valuable material goods found on this landmass, not marking a crucial location to use as a military base, and difficulty of supplying such a remote location led to the eventual abandonment of Devon Island. A similar reasoning is why other remote islands such as Heard Island or New Zealand's Auckland Island are also uninhabited, as it is simply too expensive and remote to attempt to live there. Notable geologic features on Devon Island include the following. The more than 1,000-foot deep Astronaut Canyon, the massive Oligocene-Haughton impact crater which is exposed on the surface along with the NASA training site contained within, the Miocene fossil beds within that contain rhino fossils, and the nearly 3,000-foot thick Devon ice cap that covers the entire eastern quarter of this remote island. It is beneath this ice cap that the oldest rock units are found, dating back 2.55 billion years ago to the late Archean period. These ancient rocks largely consist of gneisses and granites and are what the now abandoned Dundas Harbor settlement were constructed on top of. The rest of the island is almost entirely composed of Ordovician to Devonian sedimentary rocks, which include an assortment of sandstone, shale, limestone, and dolostone, with, for example, the notable Mars-like surface rock exposures consisting of a distinct rock unit composed of brownish-red dolostone and limestone of a Silurian period age. However, the far northwest of Devon Island contains distinctively colored red beds from the Permian period. The distinctive U-shaped valley of Astronaut Canyon denotes it as being glacial in origin, carved away by repeated glaciations during the Pleistocene epoch to form an up to 318-meter or 1,043-foot deep spectacular canyon. As for the Haughton impact crater, the exposed impact melt rock has a distinctively light gray coloration marking the interior of this 23-kilometer or 14.3-mile-wide impact feature. It formed approximately 31.9 million years ago when an 1,800-meter or 5,906-foot-wide asteroid collided with Devon Island at a velocity of 17 kilometers per second or 38,000 miles per hour, forming a complex impact crater. During the Miocene around 23 million years ago, Devon Island had a much more temperate climate resembling modern locations 4,000 kilometers to the south, leading to the development of a large lake within a section of the impact structure. It is here that animals like rhinos and relatives of the modern deer and swan were fossilized in lacustrine deposits. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Stephen Sladek, for supporting this channel.